because I would like for her to rest in peace if she was killed in the manner of which they said.
Right.
Right. Now, with that, isn't that, like, it's hard to say, like, exactly how will you feel on a day-to-day basis when it's not necessarily you who had lost their child. So, like, I understand, like, it's basically, it's mixed. Like, one day she's in a good mood, so she feel this. And one day she just, man, in one moment she really would be just sad and down and just, like, just too much for. You know what I mean? Because it's mm-hmm. like, you went from just being regular, not known, and then out of nowhere, you go on your Facebook thing and you see over 200,000 people just followed you.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't even answering your inboxes no more, because like not everybody that just coming in your inbox and just hitting you in your messenger, like how you do on the Facebook thing, just a messenger, is ain't coming with good answers. Some people was like, it went from positive to negative.
Yeah.
Hi there.
At the same time, so it's like, so it's like, it's just too much overwhelming. She never had a moment to just peace with it, just peace with it, just a peace of mind. You know what I mean?
Well, she's probably not.
Never had a moment to just have a peace of mind. Never had a moment to just like, man, sit back, cry, whatever. Cause I'm seeing like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was actually, you know what I'm saying, real proud and happy for her that she ain't never, when the camera was in her face, just broke down, cried, did the cry thing, even though I know that's what she wanted to do. You know what I mean?
Like, hey, Daryl, how are you? Are you doing all right tonight?
I'm all right.
Well, I want to start off by giving you my condolences. I lost my sister almost 10 years ago. And around that time, or a little bit after, my mom suffered from breast cancer as well. So I can kind of feel you guys' pain a little bit, you know? And, but I only have one question. You said that Teresa liked Dr. Ali. He was like her main YouTuber that he liked as far as doing research and trying to get everybody together for justice or whatever, right?
Yeah, but that guy brought to her attention. Ain't like she wouldn't have found anything. Got like kind of like
no,
brought to her attention.
No, and that's fine. However, Dr. Ali is saying that Tanika had three different types of semen inside of her when they found her. Is that true? So was Tanika raped?
That we not sure of. You know, that's what we not knowing. That's what we trying to figure out. That's what you know, they're trying to be figured out. You know, and that's what being healed.
That wouldn't come up in the autopsy or the toxicology report or anything.
Nah, she wasn't told anything like that.
So where did Dr. Ali get that from?
Didn't get told that.
Let me say this. Ali said he called the medical examiner claiming he has a phone call off video, but he said that they personally told him this. He don't got nothing documented to prove that. He also said the reason they put that in there and said that there was no actual sexual activity with her, but they found the semen, and pretty much they're trying to say that semen was on her or in her, but there was no penetration or no actual sexual penetration. This is according to what Ali said.
But then that goes against what the autopsy report says.
Exactly. He claimed they told him that on the side on a personal phone call. This is what he said. I'll leave it at that.
That's what he said. Listen, you know what I'm saying? She ain't even get to see her for a nice little minute. And then when they did
so get she to did her, get to see Kanika?
She ain't get to see her immediately. Like, how you think, like, you just get there and, like, boom, get to see her? Like, nah. She was getting bullshit around, ran around. And then when they did get to see her, they was like, first thing that came to their mind is something not right.
Okay, So when did she get to see Tanika?
Like that was like a couple of days later. Like some days.
So
later,
she got to see. So she got to see Tanika a couple of days later. After the whole hotel incident?
Like I would say, like maybe the next day, like it was okay. Like a minute. Like they came to, got sent back, came back, then seen, and then they. Then that's when they start coming up with the questions thing. Now the whole thing with the Dr. Ali, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know.
So where did Teresa actually see Tanika? Like,
did she see her in the freezer?
No.
Now, well, he said it was a couple of days later. So where was the body when Teresa actually saw her?
Oh, that little place downtown. The thing downtown, like when they see him there.
Like at the coroner's office, at the funeral home.
Yeah, it's where he's identified. Yeah, the coroner's identified.
So she had to identify the body twice?
When they first seen it, like when they went there, they get the phone call. They went there, ran around. Then later on.
Okay, so wait, hold on. I'm sorry, I don't mean to cut you off. But to make sure that we're being clear when we're speaking, where is they here?
You was breaking up. You broke up the last part.
I'm sorry, where is there? You said she went there. Where is there?
She went to the hotel.
Okay, so you said Teresa actually got a chance to see her a couple of days later. So
yeah, it wasn't there.
What did you call in the place downtown then?
The coroner's, I think.
Yeah.
So Teresa actually got to see the body twice, once at the hotel and once at the coroner's office.
Nah, they didn't let us see at the hotel.
What?
We have video surveillance from the hotel.
Not when she first got there. Not when she first got there.
Okay, I'm confused. After Tanika was dead, I want to get your timeline. I want to understand
what she first. Listen. Not when she first got there. When she first got there, it was pretty much like some bull crap around. And then she gets to see it. And then that's when they're like, all right, something wrong. But then they get to do that, the autopsy thing. I mean, and that was days later as well.
Okay, so what you're saying is that she saw her at the hotel, and then she went to see her to get the autopsy results the next day at the coroner, from the coroner's office.
Yeah, days later.
Okay, but let's go back to the hotel, okay? When did they get to see what Tanika looked like in the freezer? Did they show her Tanika in the freezer?
Yeah, it wasn't immediate though. It wasn't immediate.
But did they walk in the freezer while Tanika was in the freezer? Did she get to see her like that?
Now that I'm not sure of. That I'm not sure of. I'm not sure about that.
Wow. Unbelievable.
Okay. Okay, you know what? Let's go back to, I have a very important question that I'm still researching, and I feel like I don't want to waste any more time researching it if you might have an answer to this. It was stated in the reports, in the narrative, that right before Tanika had went to that hotel party and died, I don't know if it was that same exact day, that part is kind of unclear, but it was confirmed that it was her, that there was a shooting that happened at a liquor store off of Kedzie, where she used to, I don't know if they actually lived there, but Teresa had some property there. What did Tanika witness that night that was so tragic, that was so significant, that even the Rosemont police officers knew about it and were questioning somebody in a different jurisdiction? What happened? What did she see?
You asked a question. I don't know. I wasn't there to be able to be around and be able to see what she saw. Like,
Yeah, I'm like, do you know anything about Kanika?
Like, it probably wasn't no shit.
You know, oh, no, whoa, whoa, whoa. Like, do you know
anything? No, it was.
Hold on. Give me a minute.
Now, that's what I'm saying. Like, now with the shit there, like, I don't know if she was there for that part.
Hey, can you hear me?
They more likely just heard.
Hello?
Well, I'll tell you, they more likely just heard, man. People out here shooting every day.
Daryl.
Oh, I know that. But it was significant enough because it's even in the reports that she witnessed something and a female died that night. And then she knew both parties. Like, she knew the shooter and she knew the victim. So I just thought that, you know, because you were family or whatever, that you might have heard about some shit like that, you know? I mean, that's something that my cousin might mention to me.
That part wasn't my concern.
It wasn't your...
That part wasn't my concern. You know what I'm saying? Like, seeing
okay,
that,
I'm gonna ask you a question.
That's the West Side, man.
Yeah, okay, I'm asking you a question right now that you might not have the answers to, but I will ask you a question right now that you want that you will definitely have the answer to, okay? I'm gonna start to ask you questions that I know that you can answer. Question number one will be, when was the first time that you saw Kanika? The first time that you laid your eyes on her? Was she 10? Was she 11? Was she 2? How old was Kanika when you personally, you yourself, with your eyes, not hearsay, when did you first see Kanika? When did you first see her?
Well, I was like 1.
Maybe when she was like 1?
She was in Chicago at 1 year old.
She wasn't.
Was she in Chicago at 1 year old?
Because you already admitted that she was born and raised in Chicago.
Yeah.
So she never been to Atlanta? Never was raised in Atlanta at all.
She grew up in Chicago, man.
I asked the question, was she ever raised in Atlanta? Yes or no?
They probably did travel to Atlanta.
Oh, yes or no, bro. Come on.
Probably, okay,
yes
wait.
No.
No? So,
but did Teresa ever live in... Teresa never lived in Atlanta, though. So if Kanika was in Atlanta, she wasn't in Atlanta with Teresa, correct?
And you said the dad only been around... You said the dad been around. According to you, he ain't dead. But that cat don't be around. So what was she doing in Atlanta?
I say you'd be in and out, man.
Who was she in Atlanta with?
She was in Atlanta with him.
Who was him?
The father.
Okay, and then she moved back with Teresa when she was, it looked like from her MySpace and whatnot, it looked like she was about like 12. Is that about right?
Yeah, that should be about right.
Okay. Somewhere. That's why I said I want to ask you questions that you do have the answers to. So now we know that, you know, she was, you just saw her when she was like 1, then nobody saw her again until she was like, around 12 or 13 or whatever, because she had been in Atlanta with her father. Okay, no big deal. So that brings me to my next question. When, also in the narratives, and I'm sure if that's your family, you would know this too, that Teresa admitted, she said, it's only in one of the narratives, that the girls, a lot of them, at one point in time, I don't know what point that was, but I'm assuming it's at that same age when Kanika had came back to Chicago, that her friends even lived with her. So was Teresa a foster parent of some sort? Is that why all those young girls like stayed with her? Kanika's friends?
That just kind of is a heart type thing.
What was that you said?
Kindness of heart, you said.
Yeah,
kindness of heart.
So you're telling me that she's
like a foster parent, right? Because that's what foster parents have, kindness of heart, right?
Yeah. Come on. But it wasn't like she wasn't like getting no papers to check on them or nothing.
Say it again.
So then where did they come
from? Hold on. What you just say?
He said she wasn't getting a check for them or anything.
She wasn't getting a check.
So if that's the case, then where did they come from? Where are their parents? How did she just find these random girls that needed a place to stay? Or did they come from wherever Kanika came from when she came? Where did Monifa come from?
Was she? What do you mean by that?
I mean that, okay, when you look at the pictures of like, so she's just always been friends. Does Monifa live with Teresa?
No.
Does Monifa? Huh? Does she? You know who,
excuse me?
You know who Monifa is, right?
Come on now.
Not the cab
dance, bro.
She
nope.
Doesn't?
No.
Okay, she doesn't now. Has she lived with Teresa?
Maybe she have. I'm not sure about that. But I know she don't, though.
How are you sure that she did? Okay. Okay. How are you sure that she doesn't if you're not sure that she did? Think about
listen, that. Listen. More like to spend a night, maybe have been like that for a moment, like a lot, but nah.
No. Teresa said herself out of her mouth, or out of her, well, it's written from like in a report verbatim that she said that the girls had even lived with her. So it's not like she didn't say they would be around all the time or that they would hang out, you know, that they would come over, that they would spend. No, that's not what it said.
She said it like that. I understand how she said it like that, but when you say it, but it's just different lingo out here. That's like not necessarily understanding. She said it like that, but it's not actually like that, like living, like nah, but that's just how people say it. Like people say they take care of a lot of people a lot of times.
Okay, well that's fine, but one kind of last question about this.
You know what I mean? Like you have them, like when you have them a lot, that's what you say.
Right, but just another one of the misunderstandings and the, okay, so fine. Let's talk about what's tangible, what's not a misunderstanding. It's no misunderstanding that from a very, very, very young age, Kanika is in so, so many pictures, along with Monifa and some other friends of, or the Sierra that we talked about earlier, her too. I actually know Sierra Croft is listed as one of Teresa's associates, along with Tyra Thomas, and they're all like Kanika's age, which is why I thought maybe she was a foster parent. You're telling me she wasn't, so now I'm even more confused. But why were these girls, well, I'm not going to say why. It's clear that these girls were so obsessed with money, getting money and whatever. And they had, now we're talking like 13-year-olds. Okay. They don't have jobs, but they have stacks of money that they are fanning, throwing up. You know what I mean? Obsessed with calling themselves Money Crew and Click and Diamond Girls and Young Money Stars, and like, where did the money come from? What were they doing to get that money?
That's stunning.
No. I know that. I know. I'm not saying.
Okay,
that,
so like,
but
what, like,
but whose money was
from?
It? Then?
It was like,
whose money was it?
Man, like that, a lot of stuff just. They was doing whatever, like, to be honest, like.
All right, well, look. Daryl, I appreciate your time.
No. Just one last question. One more.
I ain't finna come up here and say, like they wasn't selling nothing. Like, they wasn't selling their body or anything like that.
Well, no, I would just wonder
like,
where it came from.
I was waiting on that. But go ahead, though, Ms. Kershaw. I just have one question for you.
The one question I have to ask you is this. Did you attend the
funeral? No, I have one question, Huggy, before you let him go.
Go to the funeral.
Oh, hold on, April. Hold on. I got you. Go ahead, Ms. Kershaw. What's that last question?
Did you go to the funeral?
Go ahead, because she was breaking up when she came in. She was breaking up. So go ahead.
Did you hear me?
Nah, I couldn't hear you breaking up.
Oh,
somebody
did you go to the funeral?
Yeah, I went.
Was her father there?
Yeah, he was there.
Hold on.
But y'all heard different.
Hold on, goddamn.
That's crazy. So, yeah, what did he look like? Where was he sitting at? What was he wearing? Like, what? Word? Daddy was there? Come on, Kenny Jenkins.
Y'all heard something different.
Goddamn right. Anyway, April, that's your last question.
That was gonna be my question. Was the dad at the funeral?
Nigga, was you at the funeral?
He said he was.
You was? Well, look. I appreciate the time, Daryl.
That's all right, man. That's what I'm trying to.
Are you calling? Okay, so well, I do have another question. Are you calling James the dad, or are you saying that Kenneth Jenkins, her biological father, was at the funeral? Because I call my stepdad dad, so I want to make sure that we're clear here.
Yeah, he was there.
Kenneth Jenkins, her biological father, was at the funeral.
Yeah, y'all heard something different and believe me.
Tap dancing. Is that the guy that was there?
So yes, Kenneth was there, and James Coleman was there?
But Kenneth Jenkins is dead on the obituary, but he shows up.
But wait a minute.
That's some magical shit right there. I ain't never heard that one.
So Kenneth and James were there. Oh, speaking of James,
yes.
Who's Lamont?
Yes, he's not gone. Yes.
Who's Lamont?
Who's Lamont?
Who's Lamont?
Yeah.
On the obituary, right beside Teresa's name in parentheses, it says Lamont. So I thought maybe that was, you know, because who isn't her boyfriend? Isn't his name James?
Yeah, James. That's what I would say. That's what we call him.
So then why on the
obituary? So James and Lamont are the same person?
Or who's Lamont?
Man, I don't know where y'all got the Lamont from, but yeah.
It's on the obituary. Fair. You were at the funeral, so you have a copy. Did you not read the obituary?
Yeah, I read.
Well, it's right there.
So you didn't see the Lamont on the obituary?
Yeah, it says her mother, Teresa, and then in parentheses it says Lamont. So I was just wondering who Lamont is. And while we're at it, who's Curtis? Senior or junior? Who's Curtis Jackson? Because you have to know who that is.
And oh, this is serious.
Oh, okay, but you know
who. Why do you think that?
But just admit to me that you do know who that is, though, right?
That's not an unfamiliar name to you, right?
You goddamn right. We want to know everybody in the family. That's the point. We want
to
help.
I'm not asking you to tell me how.
We want to help.
Or anything else. Of course, I'm just asking you if you know that name, if that's a familiar name to you.
It's familiar.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure I was on the right. Okay.
Do you want to tell us who Curtis is?
I'll tell you guys.
Since that's a.
If he doesn't want to talk about
it, go ahead. Who is Curtis Jackson?
Who, me? You want me to tell? Well, uh-huh.
I'm not finna keep speaking on everybody in our family.
I know. I was just wondering because you didn't know who, like, I don't know what's going on with these names, okay? I'm not trying to even talk about nobody. I'm not talking about anyone's character or anything else. But let me tell you something. If anything happened to my little sister, I would have no problem letting anyone know the last time I spoke to her, where she was raised, what her name was when she was born, or anything else, because it's all about getting justice and fight so that people aren't worried about this type of shit. They could be focused on fighting for justice for her. But when there's all kinds of secrets and all of the shady stuff with people like changing their story and then they want this and they don't want that type of stuff, that right there makes people feel some type of way. I'm starting to feel really played. And a lot of people
are. I have another question for you. There's Kenneka or whatever, but there was also a Kenesha Jenkins listed on the obituary.
Actually, Kenesha Jenkins Rhodes.
Right. By the way. Right.
And again, like I said, my sister died almost 10 years ago while my mom was right after that. She immediately went through breast cancer or whatever. But I knew everybody on the obituary. even if I go to a first cousin, second cousin, third cousin, if I don't know, I'm going to ask, like, who is this person? So I just want to know who Kanisha is.
I can answer that. Again, I can tell you that. That is actually...
No.
Yeah, I'm going to say chill out, Kershaw.
Yeah, are you there? You woke?
I'm here.
I think...
Okay, talk to me, Brad. They got a question. Can you answer that? Because I'm ready to go. So I want you to answer the question if you don't mind.
No, so excuse me for a minute, man. I'm just getting a little bit frustrated with the part, man. Like, I feel like
I'm frustrated, too. So you ready to go? Like, you can go. I mean, you want to go? You can leave. You ready to go? Like, anything else you want to say, Daryl?
Like, a lot of personal part of it, man. You know what I'm saying?
How is that a personal question to ask you who somebody is that's listed on the obituary?
We're not doing this.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
We're not doing this.
This reasons like this that everyone says that all of this is fake.
Hey, listen. Let me say this. For those of y'all that think I got trolled, this is funny. So at the end of the day, he got to deal with this bullshit that he's calling everybody bitches and talking about, that's my cousin and all this crazy shit. So he got to deal with that. I don't got to deal with that shit. I ain't walking around like I'm her cousin. So he got to deal with that. He live in Chicago.
He knows absolutely not a damn thing.
He don't know nothing.
Is he even still here?
No, he gone. I dropped him. Okay. I'm tired. I'm not tired because we ain't getting no answers. I'm tired because I'm just tired of him. It ain't the answer. It's him. Because
everything that you realize that everything that he says, is he actually on Teresa's page?
Everything he said, he didn't even have the audacity to take 2 seconds to watch one video. Come on now.
He ain't saying nothing.
Is he actually on Teresa's Facebook? Facebook?
I don't even know his Facebook page. He claimed that was his real name, Daryl Caesar, which that's kind of odd.
Where'd he come from? I thought, where was he leaving YouTube comments about?
He was on YouTube. He's been on YouTube for a while, though. He's just been making videos lately. And, you know, in one of his videos, he called me all type of bitches and this and that. And I was like, well, you know, I'll let you get on so you can, you know, explain yourself. So, you know, I propped him up. Now, the reason I didn't put title Kanika's cousin, because I don't know.
Exactly.
I'm only going by what he say. And if he say he Kanika's cousin, that's his fault. Not mine.
Some fucking bullshit. I was trying to be as nice as I could be. Did I do anything wrong?
No. You did wonderful. You and April.
Yeah.
Lovely. Y'all did wonderful. He said... I don't want nobody disrespecting.
What?
No, we come to a respect and you can't give an answer.
You mean to tell me that you're her cousin, but you don't even know who half these people are on the obituary?
You know who Sierra was. He said Sierra was a friend. I said, you know, that's a cousin.
No, and then he turned around.
All he did was he dug Teresa's, because if anything that he said was true, all that did was prove that everything Teresa's ever said is a lie. But they're both lying. He's trying to guess because he doesn't really know, because he's so distant of it. But he admitted to me that she didn't even live in Chicago until she was 13.
Uh-huh.
What type of shit is...
But he says she was born and raised in Chicago. That's what he said.
Right. Because you have to come at him with the actual fact before he'll admit it. If you ask him an open question, he just...
So you mean to tell me that Kenneth can come, her dad can come to the funeral and read the obituary and be like, "What the fuck did this say?"
What's up, y'all?
I said, really? Oh, my dad would be mad as hell.
And then it's like Teresa saw the body a couple of days later. Okay, where?
That boy left the funeral bump at UGK.
Oh,
and you're here, and the next day you go.
Who has feedback?
I don't know. We good.